Hello. Today I am discussing an important topic on Omicron, schools reopening, and COVID-19 vaccine for children, when it is likely to be available, and what do the stars forecast? Let's see. See, COVID-19 is almost 2 years old now. Masks and sanitizers and isolation has become part of our existence, part of human existence. But, you know, I think our children are the most affected. As adults, we are able to comprehend the situation. We are able to tide with it. But it's very difficult for the children, you know. And they are most affected by the situation of this isolation. Yes, they are able to see the faces of their classmates during online schooling. But they are unable to meet them. They are unable to connect with them. And they are not even going down to play with their peers. So how frustrating is it for the children? Children have become introverts. Many of them have developed behavioral problems. And there is no socializing with the peers and moving around constantly with a mask. It's not at all a pleasant experience for our children, I would say. Now coming to schools, some schools started in December, but few of them had to shut again when one or two cases were identified in the school. And now, like, you know, most of the schools are all set to begin on 3rd January 2022. And naturally, all the parents are worried and they are confused. More than worried, they are confused whether to send the kids to school or not. Now, looking at the number of children in each class, will there be a social distancing in the real sense? I am talking about India. Okay. So there are schools where minimum number is 30. Very few schools have 25 kids. Otherwise, there are schools where 70, 80 kids are also kept in a very large classroom, you know. So that is the situation. That also we need to think through. And social distancing is one thing. Above all, the major factor of worry is none of our children in India are vaccinated. So is it safe to send the children when they are not vaccinated? Many of my family members and friends and acquaintances reached out to me, how is the planetary condition? Those who know my passion for astrology, of course. So should we send our children to school or not? Or at least when will the vaccine for the kids be out or available in India? And of course, as an educationist, parent and grandparent, even I am worried. So I decided to study the situation. So here I am to share my knowledge. I've used my astrological knowledge about the planets and I'm sharing my knowledge with you all. But you know what? I don't force my views on anybody. These are my views. To agree or disagree, it is up to you. But, you know, I'm not the right authority to say whether to send the children to school or not. It is up to your individual discretion. I'm just sharing what I have understood, all right? And also, please watch my videos that I posted on solar eclipse of 4th December 2021 and Kulika Kala Sarpa Dosha, which I posted on of 5th December, which I posted about 2-3 weeks back. In that, I did mention that the cases of Omicron are going to increase and they are really increasing now. Omicron cases still may go on increasing stealthily without being noticed. Why? Watch my video on the eclipse. The solar eclipse has taken place in 8th house of Kala Purusha's Kundali, the natural horoscope. Okay. This is Scorpio. Now, in this Scorpio, the house of secret activity, and also Kulika Kala Sarpa Dosha also has started in 8th house, that is Scorpio, again. Now, this is all about secret, sudden events, sudden gains, sudden loss, 8th house is for that. All of us need to be very careful and, you know, take the situation quite seriously. And there is no need to panic, of course. We need to follow the safety measures and be on our guard. What happens is nowadays everybody is so fed up with the situation. I have heard people saying, How long are we going to sit at home now? It's enough is enough. Like, we are going to go out. Whatever happens, happens. That is not the right attitude. You have tolerated it for 2 years. For 4 more months, just tolerate. The situation will be better after April 30th. Okay. So that's not the right attitude. So because it has happened in the 8th house, this grahana was very strong. The solar eclipse was very strong. I have explained that in my earlier video. So what happens is everything will be sudden burst of disease, and people may not even come to know from where how it is affecting, because it's a 50th mutated version of the virus. All of you know more about it now because the internet is filled with all this information. All right, I have taken 2 dates into consideration for studying the situation. One was 1st February 2022, and the other one is 1st March 2022, to cast the horoscopes and study the situation. I haven't taken January into consideration at all because in January the cases are going to increase. And also the solar eclipse effect is quite strong in the first 2 months. So I have not considered January. I have considered 1st February and 1st March, and let us try to analyze the situation and understand what do these horoscopes signify or say. Hello. Let us first understand the first horoscope cast for 1st February 2022 at 11:55 a.m. place taken as Mumbai. See, I have selected the time to coincide with Mesha Lagna or Aries ascendant so that it would be easy for the new students of astrology and the beginners to understand it in a proper way. It is a Kala Purusha Kundali or a natural horoscope. So here, first where number one is written, that's the first house. Where two is written, that's the second house. We always read the chart in anti-clockwise direction. So it will be a perfect Kala Purusha. It is a perfect Kala Purusha Kundali. Now, if you look at the position of Rahu and Ketu, the axis is between second house and 8th house. Second house being Taurus, 8th house being Scorpio, the much discussed Scorpio sign these days after the Surya Grahana especially. And if you observe this axis, all other planets, the remaining planets, are hemmed on one side of Rahu and Ketu. So this situation is called as Kala Purusha Dosha. So that Kala Purusha Dosha is still existing. Please watch my earlier videos, which I have done on Kulika Kala Sarpa Yoga and also on the last solar eclipse to have a better understanding of this. If we consider the first house in the horoscope in this chart alongside as country itself, that is our India itself, or as the world in general. So the results what we study would be applicable to India as well as the rest of the world. It's a very generic horoscope. All right. Now the 5th house. Now what do we see from the 5th house? 5th house, first of all, we need to understand it is one of the Shubha Sthanas or auspicious houses, triangular signs or Konasthana we say. So it forms a perfect triangle. One, first house, then five, fifth house, nine. So this is also called as Dharma Trikona. I'm not going to get into those details right now. So what is important to understand right now is what all we can predict from 5th house. Why I'm considering 5th house and not any other house. Each and every house in the horoscope has certain things where we can study. It throws light on certain areas. So 5th house, we see good karma or your Purva Punya. What good past deeds you have done so that you have got this life, and what are you going to do further? Those things. And we can study about one's success and failure. If it's a country ka success and failure. Then artistic inclinations. Then trends of stock market also can be seen. And also your romantic interests. Whether, like it will be one of the sanas only on 5th house. I can't predict all this. Whether you are going to get, if it's the individual horoscope, I mean, whether it will be a love marriage or whether your love affair will be successful or whether you will just have romantic interest but you're not interested in getting into any serious kind of relationships. The 5th house, along with other few houses, we study those situations. Anyway, now Most importantly, fifth house is also called as Putrasthana, Sutasthana or Santanasthana, meaning house of children. Now, what do I mean by house of children? Everything and anything related to children is studied from this. If it's an individual horoscope, whether your children are going to be good and whether they are going to take care of you or what will be your relation with your children, where is the fifth lord based on all these things. But right now, what we are going to consider, and also fifth house, throws light on education and educational institutions. So I'm not going to consider everything here because our focus is to see, because the question that came to me is whether to send the children to school or not, and are the schools going to reopen, and, you know, is it safe to send children, or at least when the vaccine will be available. So pertaining to that, I'm going to consider fifth house for studying actually education, educational institution, and children. Children is the first priority. That's what we are thinking. So let us focus on the fifth house. Okay. There is a direct aspect of Jupiter on the fifth house. Now, where is Jupiter placed currently? He is in Kumbh Rashi or Aquarius sign. So directly he is aspecting. This is a very good sign. Okay. Now, more than where Jupiter is posited, his view or his aspect or his, drishti is more beneficial. So here though, he is giving a sampurna drishti to fifth house. It means something good is going to happen. You know, that is one thing. Other than that, there are no other aspects anywhere. Like, you know, Rahu also has got the aspect 5, 7 and 9. Rahu is not aspecting this house. And all other planets also, nobody is having any aspect on this fifth house. Now, what is the fifth house as per Kala Purusha's Kundali? It is Leo or Simha Rashi. Who rules Simha Rashi? Of course, Ravi or Surya or Sun. Now, fifth house is also coming under the, Karakatva, we say. Karakatva means the responsibility of a Jupiter planet. All right? Because it's a Shubhasthana, Purva Punyasthana, Sutasthana. All right. Now, where is the fifth lord? Now, we need to check not just the fifth house. It's an empty house right now, as you see here. And only Jupiter's aspect is there. But that doesn't end the studies. We have to check up where this fifth lord or Panchamadhipati, lord of fifth house, that is Surya or Sun, is placed. Now, as you observe, Surya is right now in this horoscope, if you see, he is placed in enemy camp. Who is his enemy? Saturn. And mythologically, Surya and Saturn share a relation of father and son. Surya is the father and Saturn is the son. But they are inimical towards each other. There is a long story about mythology, which I don't want to deviate from the topic. I have to speak about what I want to right now. So, he's in an enemy camp. Just imagine, if you are put in an enemy camp, however powerful you are, however, you want to do so many things, but still you have to wait and watch and wait till you move out of that camp. That is the logic over here. Because it's not a very happy situation. Even Saturn also is uncomfortable because his father, who is inimical, is in his house and Sun is so really, really unhappy. Now, in such situation, they will not harm each other. They are just tolerating each other. But still, Saturn is in a better position because the enemy has come to my house. So I have an upper hand. Or, I can say if he starts behaving funny, I can say, please get out. I don't want you in my house. But Sun cannot do that. He has to tolerate. He has to stay here. There's no choice to move out before time. So that is the logic. Now, who is Surya? Surya or Sun is called as Atma Karaka. As long as Atma is existing in the body, we all are alive. All right? So he is Atma Karaka. He's called as Jiva Karaka. He's the one who is responsible for every form of life and energy in this world. There is a beautiful hymn in Surya Stuti that describes him as describes Surya. Om Namah Savitre Jagadeka Chakshuse Jagat Prasuti Stiti Nasha Hetuve Tvayi Mayaya Trigunatma Dharine Virinchi Narayana Shankaratmane. Now, what do we mean by this? Om Namah Savitre Jagadeka Chakshuse. I offer my namaskaras to you, O Surya. You are the only eye of the world. Eye is most the significant organ, right? So you are the only eye of the world. I'm able to see the world with because you are there. See, again, if you think scientifically, only in the light we are able to look around and see because of the reflection of, rays falling on the object. So you are the only eye of the world, means I am able to perceive everything and look at, see the world only because of you. Jagat prasuti sthiti nasha hetuve, sthiti nasha, jagat prasuti, prasuti is the creation, sthiti is maintenance, nasha, of course, you know, destruction. So you are the one who is responsible for birth, sustenance and destruction of the world. You are the Atma and Trinity. Virinchi, Narayana, Shankara means Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara. So you are the protector, you are the, sustainer and you are the destructor. So you protect all the three gunas in the self. So that is the hymn for Surya. Now, such a Surya who is so important, he is called as king of planets. He is put in an enemy camp and Surya doesn't have any other drishti. He has only one house to rule, that is the fifth house or Leo, and he aspects only the opposite sign. Now, here in this case, Surya is aspecting the fourth house in the Kalapurushas Kundali. Fourth house represents what? Fourth house represents Sukhasthana, it is called as. All your comforts and luxuries and happiness and everything is seen from fourth house. So that is a good thing. But we are looking at now something related to children. All right, this is about Surya, I said. Now let us look at another planet called as Pluto. Now Pluto generally for individual predictions I don't consider because it's a very slow moving planet, It remains in the sign for years and years, and its number of years also is not fixed. I think in this particular sign, that is Vrishchika Rashi, it remains for about 9 years, I think. Now, Pluto is so slow moving that it takes 248 years to complete one revolution around the sun, you can imagine. Now, it is actually smaller than our moon. Moon is a satellite of the Earth and this planet is smaller than the Moon and it is quite far away. And it's quite a young planet to be included in the astrology and astronomy. And it's quite far away. And it was discovered, I think, in 1930. And I have taken it over here because it is a malefic planet. And another trait of Pluto is Pluto affects the large masses. Rather than individuals, it affects the people in large number. That is why I have taken. And also, Pluto is supposed to rule the natural sign of 8th house, that is Scorpio. So everything, lot of activities are happening in Scorpio. That's the reason I have considered this. Now, apart from that, look at the position of Mars now. Mars is in the 12th house from 10th house in conjunction with Venus. Now, what do I mean by this? Mars is actually in the... Sagittarius sign or Dhanu Rashi. So this 9th house becomes 12th from the Vyasthana of 10th house. So and Mars, and another auspicious planet is Venus. Venus also is a Shubhagra. That is also conjuncting with Mars. So Mars and Venus, when they combine, the other things get activated. The romantic interest and the partners and so many things they get activated. Both the energies, these are typical male and female energies. When they come together, you can understand. It also means creation, I don't deny it, but it's happening in the 12th house. So they are not very beneficial in this horoscope. Now, Moon and Mercury are doing their bit. Okay. So actually, Moon and Mercury are also completely aspecting over the fourth house here so that some activity for the happiness has to go on. So in this case, what will be our happy moment when we conquer this virus or be completely prepared? So how can we do that? We can that can be done by finding out newer and better booster drugs, and also for our children, the vaccination for children is the most important thing. Okay. So but actually with this combination, results may not come out in the February, but The activity is going on, the research is going on. In the positive direction, something is moving. That much I can see from this report. But remember, the cases of COVID may go on increasing in the February due to the effect of earlier Surya Grahana or solar eclipse that is still very, very strong. So we need to be extremely careful in this. Now let us see what is the ma horoscope for March going to convey to us. So now let us analyze the second horoscope cast for 1st March 2022. Time taken as 10:10 a.m. and place taken as Mumbai. See, Kala Sarpa Dosha is still existing. We can have a look at the horoscope, but it is in the last few degrees. Okay. Now we have five planets in the 10th house. You can observe alongside there is Mars, Saturn, Moon, Venus, and Mercury. So five planets are already in conjunction or they are together. Now we are also considering Pluto now, as I explained earlier why I'm taking Pluto. So in actually we are having six planets in this 10th house. So very, very active house right now. Sun has finally moved out and he is in the 11th house along with Jupiter. Jupiter is a benefic planet. He is a Shubha Graha. And Sun is directly aspecting his own house, fifth house or Santanasthana or Putrasthana is Sun's own house. So he rules that house. So he is directly aspecting. Jupiter also is directly aspecting. And Sun is also called as Dhanvantari. Dhanvantari, a celestial healer or Vaidya or a celestial doctor, we can say. So he controls all the Aushadhas and Aushadhiya Vanaspati. What do I mean by this? All the medicines and medicinal plants. So there is a rulership over these things. So this is a very, very good sign. Now Sun is in the star of Rahu, that is Shatavisha. Sun is placed in Shatavisha. Shatavisha is the star that is ruled by Rahu. Now Rahu is, though he is placed in the second house, he is aspecting the 10th house through his ninth drishti, Navam drishti. Okay, so Rahu's thing is wherever he casts his eye, he enhances. Rahu is all about greed, but it should not be taken always in the negative sense. Whatever you are doing, he expands that phala, he enhances that phala. Okay, so Rahu enhances the action of that house, that what we are discussing, the 10th house. And interestingly, Rahu is in Kritika Nakshatra. Now this Kritika star is ruled by Sun. And just understand, like, there are these two planets. Sun is sitting in Rahu star, Rahu is sitting in Sun star. A kind of Parivartana Yoga where placement of Nakshatra is concerned. I can give an example. They have to be nice to each other and they have to pretend, even if they are not friends, they have to pretend to be friends. See, it is like this. If I have one glass house and you have another glass house, we exchange. I sit in your house, you are sitting in my house. So, even if it is for a temporary period. Now, I may be really wanting to damage this house because I don't like you. But that fear is there for me. If I throw one stone and break one of your glasses, you are not going to keep quiet. You're going to, throw two stones and break two of my glasses. So that is the situation. So Rahu and Sun are not great friends. In fact, Rahu is the one who causes eclipses and all that. They hate each other. But because of this situation, they have to tolerate each other and pretend to be friends. Oh, how are you? Oh, I'm good, I'm good. How are you? I'm good, I'm good. Thank God he has not damaged my house. This kind of a situation. All right. Now, Mars, planet Mars, now in the earlier horoscope, he was, one place behind. He was in the 12th house of 10th house. Now he has moved to 10th house. He is in Makara or Capricorn. Mars also is in Uttarashadha, which is ruled by Sun, the star. Okay. And Mars is a planet of action. Mangal is called as Senapati or Commander in Chief. What is the duty of Commander in Chief? He has to put everything into action. It is not just barging into fight. He has to strategize. Lot of strategies are required. How do I go? Where do I do? What do we do? Which person I'll employ where? So all those kind of things also He doesn't believe in laying back. Okay, let me see. Oh, enemies are attacking. Let me see. Tomorrow I will think. Today I'm not keeping well, or I'm not in a mood tomorrow. No, Mars will never say that. Mars will say instant, instant, instant. Abhikabhi, abhikabhi, that kind of a thing. So he supports the thinking process also, logic also, and research and result also. If you do research, you'll have to get results. So he accelerates the whole process, Mars. So this, he is aspecting the fifth house with his eighth drishti. So Mars has got the three drishtis. One is a fourth one, then seventh one, and eighth one. So three drishtis are there. So through his eighth drishti, he is aspecting this house. Moon is a benefic planet, and Moon is mind again. So mind has to be properly activated to do anything, whether you want to do a research or whether you want to even get into the war or warlike situation. So Moon is benefic, and he is in Dhanishta. So Dhanishta is again ruled by Mangal, Mars, Dhanishta star. So Moon also in a way provides energy to Mars. Okay, you are doing some good work, so I am with you. So he enhances that. So he supports the actions of Mars. Venus also has moved to 10th house. Venus is in Uttarashada again. Who rules Uttarashada? This is again Sun. So he will also, Venus also provides, a benefic energy or a good energy to Sun and the entire activity in that house. So it gives the result. So Mercury is benefic, and he provides intelligence and intellect. And all these planets, remember, they are looking at the fourth house. Fourth house is a Sukhasthana. When you will get Sukha, or when you will get comfort, or when you will get happiness, when all your problems are sorted out, right? So that is the thing. And then Pluto, as I said, Pluto no doubt is a malefic planet, but Pluto also is in Uttarashada. Uttarashada is again ruled by Sun. So Pluto, as I said earlier, it affects a large population. So this will also help in help Sun in whatever activities are going on here, and it gives a favorable, it enhances the favorable results. So due to all these factors, I conclude that better booster doses for adults and COVID-19 vaccination for children all across the world, of course in India also, should be available by around the first week of March. Maybe it is 2 weeks earlier or 2 weeks later, but I can't give an exact date and exact time frame. But around this time, definitely a solution will be found. That much I can, definitely say. So viewers, this is my analysis of the present situation. And let us keep our fingers crossed. Everything works out well. Only thing, as I said, there is no need to panic. It is like guidance. See, I'll tell you, some people, though, they say, I don't believe in astrology. Whatever things are going to happen are going to happen. Then that is up to you. I'm not forcing my views on anybody. I'll just give an example. Today, what is our custom, especially in Mumbai and Chennai and all other places where we are, I mean, Delhi, where we expect traffic jams and all that. So what do? We refer to Google Map and then check out. Okay, this road is clogged. I know my destination. So then we check out which way I have to take and drive down. If you say, "Arey, whatever is going to happen, why should I bother about the traffic jam? Jab aayega tab dekhega," then you go. You get stuck in the jam, get frustrated, and then spend 4 hours of your precious lifetime. And see, 4 hours, they are not of a day. They are of your life. If I'm sitting and making this video and spending time in recording and researching about a week, I've been going through all the combination, referring to so many books, it means actually I am giving the time of my lifetime, because every minute we are nearing to the last final date, which is unknown to all of us. So with that commitment, I work. So what I mean to say is astrology need not be taken as something to get scared or, need not be just brushed away. It is a guidance. If I come to know which road is clogged, I will not go. I will circumvent that and I will try to reach my destination through other things. So it is exactly like this. So here, what are we supposed to do? Be extremely careful. Don't take this virus, that corona, so easily. Omicron, whatever has come. Some people even mentioned to me, no, Omicron is not fatal like corona. People are getting fast and recovering. It's very good. People are this thing, but you don't even exposed to that, no? Why you should suffer, even if it is for a temporary period? Why you want to get it? Because nobody knows the nature of the virus, how it's going to come back, how it's going to mutate. So this is all I can say. And if I am given the authority, or if my personal opinion is, it is already 2 years almost kids have done online schooling, at least for the little ones. Now I think in India the vaccination is going to be available soon, in a week's time or something, for 15 plus year old. If you want to start the high school section, that's okay. But at least for middle school, primary school, and pre-primary, I feel it's not worth taking risk, because the cases of Omicron are going to rise. And there will be some respite and something after the 30th April, Kala Sarpa Dosha breaks. And it will start coming down by then. Immediately, it is not a magic wand that, okay, Kala Sarpa is broken, and immediately we can go back to our normal life, what we had 2 years back. That bindas attitude. And no, it is not like that. The virus is not going to magically disappear from this earth. It may take another couple of years, okay, so to completely eradicate it or completely gain control over it. So the effect of eclipse is still there. And we should be careful up to 30th April, later on also. But it will go on reducing, and we will be perhaps in a better situation, better condition, well protected, well equipped, and well prepared to handle the situation. That is what I mean. So if you like my video and the logical explanation, please share it with the like-minded people and subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions, you may post them in the comment box, and I'll try to answer them as and when I get time. As I told, a little bit of time crunch I face because I'm into so many things. I have to look after my professional work also, and this also. But it is my passion, and it's a pleasure to get connected to you and share my knowledge. Thank you for watching. God bless.